Hello and welcome to our 5 minutes with Ekaterina, Ukrainian poetry. Today let's go back to the classics and read together poetry written by a great poet Taras Shevchenko. We have already read his most famous verses. You can search on the channel and you can reread them. And there I mentioned some facts of Taras Shevchenko's biography. And I didn't mention back then that Taras Shevchenko during his lifetime was single. He didn't have a chance to get married, but he tried to propose different women different times, several times. And one of these occasions happened in 1845, when he firstly, after the long years out of Ukraine, he went to Ukraine, and in the small village Kirillivka, he wanted to marry the daughter of a priest whose name was Feodosia Koshets. The problem was that the years before he worked for her parents as a worker, and they were rich, and of course he got the refusal. Actually, the girl herself, she liked him and maybe loved even, but her parents were in the very opposite side, and they forbid this marriage. And this unsuccessful marriage raised for him questions of bigger scale of inequality, of personal freedom versus unfreedom. And let's read the first poem, which was written shortly after this unsuccessful marriage arrangement, and then the second one, which is reflecting a little bit different position. So they're a little bit different, but they are both driven by the same idea of inequality and of inability to get something if you are not rich enough. Taras Shevchenko, «Не завидуй багатому». Не завидуй багатому, багатий не знає ні приязні, ні любові. Він все те наймає. Не завидуй могучому, бо той заставляє. Не завидуй і славному. Славний добре знає, що не його люди люблять, а ту тяжку славу, що він тяжкими сльозами вилив на забаву. А молоді, як зійдуться, та любо, та тихо, як у раї. А дивишся, ворушиться лихо. Не завидуй же нікому, дивись кругом себе. Нема раю на всій землі, та нема й на небі. So isn't it beautiful? Isn't it a beautiful teaching? You know, we shouldn't be jealous, we shouldn't be envy for somebody, because under every surface happiness, under every great thing, there is something deeper, and behind it sometimes stands something ugly that we don't want to experience in our lifetime. And these lines, it was written again, the poem was written in the 19th century, and Taras Shevchenko and his attitude to religion is still a discussional question, because at that time everybody in Ukraine and in Russian Empire generally, they were Orthodox Christians, and Taras Shevchenko in these verses in 1845 writes «Нема раю на всій землі, та немай на небі». There is no paradise on the earth, but there is also no paradise on heavens. And this is so revolutionary, and this is so atheistic, I would say, that the magazine where the poem was firstly printed in 1861, years and years after it was written, the magazine changed the last lines into «Нема раю на всім світі, хіба що на небі». There is no paradise in this world, but probably it is there on heavens. And this is changes actually the whole poem, and the idea of the whole poem is changed completely. And actually, this is the same that we can read in this famous Zapovit poem. We read it together before, where he is writing that there is no paradise until Ukraine is free. So this idea of being religious and not believing at the same time, adopting the religion itself, is very interesting, and we literally don't know the original attitude of Taras Shevchenko towards religion. And in this poem, you can see it clearly. This is one of the examples. Please write me in the comments if you think that these lines are actually stating that the heavens exist and in the future life we will suffer too, or maybe some of us will be saved. How do you perceive these lines? It's very interesting because probably different people will have different ideas towards these verses, these last verses. And also let me know which ones you like better. But as I promised you, let's go to the reading of the second one. And here we don't really see the idea of rejection anymore such clearly, but we see the idea, this controversy of being lonely, being alone and being free. So what is better for the person, to be completely free or to stay together? And if it's easier for people to be together as a couple or just to live a life as a single person? And again, we are talking about the 19th century, and we are talking at the time about the times where to be married is the only normal way of thinking. It's not our times where we can choose it freely, but at this time it was very predetermined how you should behave. And Taras Shevchenko here is questioning this predetermination, and he's questioning the whole idea of marriage. And let's read it together. Let's see how it's written in verses. Не женися на багатій, бо вижене з хати. Не женися на убогій, бо не будеш спати. Оженись на вольній волі, на козацькій долі, яка буде, така й буде. Чи гола, то й гола. Та ніхто не докучає і не розважає. Чого болить і де болить, ніхто не питає. Удвох кажуть і плакати, мов легше, неначе. Не потурай. Легше плакать, як ніхто не бачить. The poem was written the very same year. These two poems, they were written this very short time span. Here you can see the Cossacks' freedom. If you remember, Cossacks were free warriors on the territory of present-day Ukraine, and they didn't get marriages. They were free without wives. That was early Cossacks. They didn't get married. And Taras Shevchenko is putting this controversy between free people, free men without family, and this couple, which you cannot really choose if your future wife should be rich or poor or whatever. So let me know your idea about this poem too, about the correlation between these two poems, and what is actually your idea about the freedom. I'm always excited to read your comments. As for me, both these verses are strong, both these poems are very strong, and I perceive them as the part of rebellion and the very noble idea as for 19th century that today we get as for granted, as if it's normal. But let's just imagine how revolutionary it was back then. And we are still reading them, and we are still actually putting these questions in front of us every time we are trying to get into relationships. That's it. That's our reading for today. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget about your likes. And if you can, please consider supporting me on Patreon. That's exactly how I can create more such videos. Thank you very much for watching. And I hope to meet you very soon in our next episodes. Goodbye for now.